Analytics is an important part of any website. It can help you identify UX issues, identify what content is popular with your users, and ultimately help you optimize your content and website so you can provide the most value to your users. And so in today's video, we're gonna walk through adding Google Analytics to a Gatsby site so you can start getting the most out of your content. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. Today we're gonna walk through installing Google Analytics plugin on a Gatsby site, talk about some plugin configuration options, walk through how to track custom events, and finally walk through how to track outbound links. If you want to follow along with today's demo, you'll need to have a Gatsby framework installed and have a Google Analytics account set up. So let's get started. As a starting point, I've got a out-of-the-box Gatsby site that I've created using the Gatsby new command. The first thing we're going to do is install the plugin. Let's go to the Gatsby site and go to the plugin section. If we search for Google Analytics, you'll see that there's several plugins. We're going to use the most common one. That's the official one. And we're going to copy the plugin name and then go back to Visual Studio and open up a terminal. I use Yarn for my dependency manager. So I'm going to run a Yarn add and then paste in the plugin name. Then after the Yarn add command completes, the second piece is to add the plugin to the Gatsby config plugin section. So let's go back to the Gatsby plugin page, and you'll notice that it has a lot of options you can include. We're going to start off by just adding the minimum required, which is just the tracking ID property. We'll switch back to Visual Studio and paste that in. I would recommend putting it at the top of the plugin section. According to the plugin's documentation page, there are known issues with the plugin not loading properly on the DOM if you don't put it at the top. Now we need to go to Google Analytics and find our tracking ID to paste in this setting. So I'm already logged into Google Analytics. Once you're logged in, go to the admin section, and then for your property, go to the property settings and you'll find the tracking ID. Copy that value and go back to Visual Studio and paste it in the plugin settings. Now let's test our setup. One thing to note about the Google Analytics plugin is that in order to test the settings locally, you need to be running in production mode. To run in production mode, you need to run a Gatsby build and then a Gatsby serve command. Now we can open up our site locally, clicking on this link that it gives us. Let's open up the site side by side with our Google Analytics account. Let's go back to the reporting section of Google Analytics. And the easiest way to test locally is go to their real-time section and go to the content section. Now let's click around on our site a little bit. And then in a few seconds, we start seeing the traffic show up in Google Analytics. And so we know our plugin is configured correctly. Now let's talk about a few of the optional settings you can add to your Gatsby config plugin section. The plugin's documentation page does a good job of documenting all the different options. And so I'm not going to go over every single one. I do want to call out a few that I think may be some of the more common ones that you'll use. So let's switch back to Visual Studio. And I'm going to paste in four optional parameters. The first parameter is the head parameter. This parameter determines where the Google Analytics tracking code is placed. If it's set to true, Gatsby places the code in the head section of the HTML document. If it's set to false, it's placed in the body section. Google's documentation recommends that the tracking code be placed in the head section, and so I'm going to include this parameter and set it to true. The next two optional parameters I'm going to include are the anonymize and respect DNT. These two settings are related to privacy. Setting the anonymize parameter to true will tell Google Analytics to anonymize the IP address. I know this parameter may be required by some countries like Germany to comply with their privacy laws. The next one I'll call out is the respect DNT parameter. If you set this parameter to true, Google Analytics will not be loaded at all for visitors that have the do not track option in their browser enabled. I don't consider myself an expert on privacy laws and the settings related to privacy, but from what I understand, Google Analytics is not considered tracking, and so this setting may not be required to comply with privacy laws. Before deciding if you need to include either of these privacy settings, I'd recommend you read up on the subject or consult somebody that is more familiar with privacy laws. The last one we'll cover is the page transition delay. If you're using any custom transitions on route updates, this may be one that you look into if you start to experience any issues with the Google Analytics data being collected. Now let's talk about custom event tracking. The plugin exposes a function that allows you to track custom events. An example of a custom event you might want to track is if a person clicked on a button that opens a modal, or if you had a FAQ section that was within an accordion and you wanted to track which specific items were being used within that FAQ accordion. To demonstrate this, let's add a simple button to our homepage, and then we'll add the needed code to send a custom event to Google when a user clicks on that button. The first thing we'll do is add an import statement for the track custom event function, and then we'll replace our image on our homepage with a simple button. And then I'll paste in the code to fire the custom event. Basically, we're just adding an onClick event to our button that calls the track custom event function and passes a category, action, and label to Google Analytics. Now let's run a Gatsby build and Gatsby serve so we can test our custom event. Now we'll go back to Google Analytics and our website and refresh the page. And we see our new Click Me button. Then if we go to the events section of the real-time reporting and change it to display the events for the last 30 minutes, then we can come to our page and click the button. And then after a few seconds, we see our event shows up in Google Analytics. One last thing I'll show you is the outbound link component. The plugin provides this component so you can track outbound links. One good example of how you might use this is adding them to your social media links in your footer, so you can track when a user clicks on those. To use this component, first let's add the outbound link component to our import statement. Then I'm going to paste in two instances of the outbound link component, one to my YouTube channel and one to my Facebook page. Just like normal links, all you have to provide is a href value and a target. Let's run another Gatsby build and Gatsby serve. And then we'll go back to Google Analytics and our website and test our change. We'll refresh the page and we see our two new links. I'll click on the YouTube link. And we see that that event fired in Google Analytics. Then also we can click on the Facebook link. And we see that it fired as well. If you want to drill into details, you can click on the outbound link category and it will break it down by the pages that were clicked on. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like. Make sure to subscribe if you want more content and web best practices. Also, if you have any other questions about adding Google Analytics to a Gatsby site, feel free to leave me a question below and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.